فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So he's missing that. So he's criticized because of his adala that is missing. وَمَنْ خَرَجَ عَنْ حَدِّ الْعَدَالَةِ Anyone who leaves the realm of adala, he leaves it. لَا يُعْتَمَدُ عَلَى صِدْقِ His truthfulness is not relied on. You see? وَإِنْ صَدَقَ فِي شَيْءٍ بِعَيْنِهِ فِي حَالَةٍ مِنَ الْأَحْوَالِ Even if he tells a truth in a particular scenario or a particular matter, إِلَّا أَنْ يَظْهَرَ عَلَيْهِ ضِدُّ الْجَرْحَ حَتَّى يَكُونُ أَكْثَرَ أَحْوَالِهِ طَاعَةُ اللَّهِ Unless it becomes clear. The opposite to the criticism, which is what? أَنْ يَكُونَ that he is. أَكْثَرَ أَحْوَالِهِ that the majority of his situations are the obedience of the Messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَحِينَئِذِ يُحْتَجُ بِخَبَرِهِ So he does fisq, but the majority of the times he's doing what? He's on point, his ta'a is more. فَحِينَئِذِ يُحْتَجُ بِخَبَرِهِ His khabar is then relied upon. فَأَمَّا قَبْلَ ذُهُورِ ذَلِكَ عَنْهُ As for before that becomes clear, which is that he's away from fisq, فَلَا no. Number six, from the criticism that I put to the narrator. Ibn Hajar says, الوهم. 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 وهم means what? وهم is تخيله. Is to be, to see something different to what it is. The way you think. And what would it be in English? To hallucinate in something. نعم. Is to see something in a particular way. Is to see something in a particular way. اصطلاحا, that's what it means linguistically. اصطلاحا, it means هو رواية الحديث. It is narrating a hadith على سبيل التوهم. To narrate a hadith in a way and a form of التوهم. By believing that this is what it is, but then hallucinating in it. بناء على طرف المجروح المقابل للظن. عبد الرحمن بن مهدي رحمه الله he said الناس ثلاثة the people are three types رجل حافظ متقن a person is a حافظ his memory is on point serious فهذا لا يختلف فيه that one there's no dispute taking his narration on point حافظ he's a حافظ he's a متقن وآخر another one يهم he does وهم sometimes والغالب على حديث الصحة but the majority of his narration is authenticity فهذا لا يترك حديثه this one his narrations are not left he does وهم sometimes but the majority of times he's on point he comes with authentic narrations this one his narrations are not left وآخر the other one يهم والغالب على حديث الوهم he does وهم and the majority of the times is وهم the majority of the times فهذا يترك حديثه this one his narrations are left His narrations are left. Khatib al-Baghdadi mentions that in his Kitab al-Kifaya, and also Tirmidhi mentions it, and Tirmidhi mentions it in his Ilal. He mentions that in his Al-Ilal. So the wahm means a person hallucinates in something. He sees it in a way. Number seven, which are the criticism that are put to the narrator. Which is مخالفة الثقات. مخالفة الثقات. مخالفة الثقات means that the person he opposes the ثقات, the reliable people. What does he do? He opposes the ثقات. Opposing the ثقات are five types. The مخالفة الثقات are five types. The opposing of the thiqat are five types. One is what? Is mudraj, maqloob, al-mazidu fi mutasil al-asanid, mudaribu, and the musahhaf. Those five are what? They're the five types which the mukhalafat al-thiqat, it falls under mukhalafat al-thiqat. The first one is called mudraj. The second one is called al-maqloob. The third one is called al-mazidu fi mutasil al-asanidi. Al-mazidu fi mutasil al-asanidi. So the first one is al-mudraj, the second one is al-maqloob, The third one is al-mazidu fi muttasil al-asanidi. The fourth one is al-muddaribu. Al-muddaribu. The fourth one is al-muddaribu. And the fifth, which is the last one, is called al-musahhafu. The last one is called, the fifth one, is called al-musahhafu. And inshallah, we're going to come to each one of them in details. This one is also a what? Is also a, it's a criticism that goes towards the narrator. And this goes towards his dabd, his memory. It's one of the ones that we mentioned regarding the dabd, his memory. What does it mean? It means he goes against the, there's a mukhalafatu thiqat. He's opposing the thiqat. He opposes the thiqat. And the way he opposes the thiqat is in those five ways that we mentioned. Either it's mudraj, or it's maqloob, or al-mazidu fi muttasil al-asanid, or muddarib, and last but not least, it's musahhaf. Okay? Those five ways is how it happens. And if a narrator is known, he is known to what? Oppose a lot. The narrator, it's a criticism that's put to him. If he's opposing the thiqat, the scholars who are reliable. Thiqat, brothers, I've said it to you guys, is man jama'a bayna sifatay. It's a person who combines between the two characteristics, which is adala and dhabt. Both of them are on point. That person is called a thiqa. Thiqa is a person who's dhabt. And his adala, both of them are on point. That person is called a thiqa. He opposes them. Anyone who opposes a thiqa, there is the thiqa, a person, the thiqat, he opposes them, he's not a thiqa now. Why? Because he's dhabt, his memory is now missing. His memory is missing. If his opposition is, if he is a person who is a thiqah himself, are you with me? And he is opposing other thiqat, then what's the hadith that he's, what's going to be said to his hadith? Shad. He's a thiqah, he opposed other thiqat, his hadith is called shad. If he is weak and he opposes, it's called munkar. It's called munkar. Iraqi rahimahullah, he says, وَمَنْ يُوَافِقْ غَالِبًا ذَا الطَّبْطِ فَطَابِطٌ أَوْ نَادِرًا فَمُخْطِي. So, the opposition. And don't worry, inshallah, all those five that I mentioned, we're going to come to them. All of them, we're going to take them. The eighth one is, which is the criticism of the narrator, is al-jahala. Jahala. Means what? The narrator is not known. Jahl. He's anonymous. He's unknown. He is anonymous. Jahala. We all know what the jahl and jahala is the opposite of naqidu al-ilm. It's the opposite to knowledge. It's the opposite to knowledge. Jahl is the opposite to knowledge. Well, jahlu ala thalathat adrubin. Ignorance is of how many types? Three. The ignorance is of three types. First one is خلو النفس من العلم. That the person, the absence of knowledge in the individual. And that's the original meaning of the word jahl, ignorance. It's the knowledge is absent from this person. The second one is called اعتقاد الشيء. It is to believe something على خلاف ما هو عليه, opposite to the reality of it. Which is, the first one they normally call it what? جهل بسيط. And the second one they call it جهل مركب. Okay? The first one is, basically, he doesn't know anything. You ask him, what is a حافظ مثلا? And he says to you, لا أدري. So you say, this is جهل بسيط. The second one you say to him, brother, what's حافظ? And he says to you, it's a milk. It's the name of a milk that's bought from Tesco's. مثلا. You say, that's جهل مركب. Because why? He believes it to mean something opposite to what it really is. Are you with me? The second, third type is what? فعل الشيء is to do something. بخلاف ما حق أن يفعل is to do something opposite to the way it deserves for it to be really done. is for you do something opposite to the way it should be really done. Are you all with me? And that's the one Allah used in the Quran. إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَاهَالَةٍ Allah says that the people who do the sin, who repent, Allah says, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ, that the repentance is for who? إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ, for the who? الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ, the ones who do the sin, بِجَاهَالَةٍ, with ignorance. Now you would think to yourself, what about if the person knew that the sin was haram and he did it? Is the eye not allowing him in it? We will say no. The jahl here is referring to anyone who does an action opposite to how it should. If he does an action opposite to the way it should have been done, then this person, jahl is something that's given to him, regardless of whether he knows it or not. Okay? The scholars of hadith, they consider a jahalatul rawi, a narrator to be jahil. It's a person, they say, man la yu'rafu fi ta'deel wa la tajreeh. It's any person who criticism and praise is not known of him. That person is called jahala, unknown. Criticism on him is not known, and praise is not known on him, specifically. That person in their eyes is called a jahala, unknown. He is what? Unknown. Al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, he said, أَنَّ الْمَجْهُولَ Khatib al-Baghdadi said, the majhul is, مَنْ لَمْ يَشْتَهَرْ It's anyone who's not famous. For what? بِطَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ Anyone who's not famous for seeking knowledge. He's not famous for it. فِي نَفْسِهِ In himself, وَلَا عَرَفَهُ الْعُلَمَاءِ بِهِ And the scholars don't know that for him. They don't know that for him. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَعْرِفْ وَلَمْ يُعْرَفْ حَدِيثَهُ And his narrations are not known إِلَّا مِنْ جِهَةِ رَاوٍ وَاحِدٍ Except from one particular narrator. His narrations only come to us from one narrator. So that person is a مجهول, unknown. Ibn al-Salah refuted Khatib al-Baghdadi on that definition. And what did he say? He said to him, قَدْ خَرَّجَ الْبُخَارِيُّ حَدِيثَ جَمَاعَةِ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ إِلَّا رَاوٍ وَاحِدٍ He said, Bukhari, Imam al-Bukhari, he narrated in his Sahih, a group of people who don't have except one narrator. Who don't have except what? One narrator. Who brought, Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his book a people who we don't know the narration except through one person. So, for example, Mirdas al-Aslami. Nobody narrated from him, except Qais ibn Abi Hazim. So, he said that's not Musallam. Same is who? Imam Muslim. Such as who? Rabi'at ibn Ka'b al-Aslami. Nobody narrated from him except who? Abi Salamah ibn Abd al-Rahman. So that is... Nawawi answered for who? Khatib al-Baghdadi. And Imam al-Nawawi came, and so what did Nawawi do? Nawawi gave an answer on behalf of Khatib al-Baghdadi, an answer to who? To Ibn Salah. He said to him, وَالصَّوَابُ نَقْلُ الْخَطِيبِ Khatib's transmission is correct. He's not wrong. وَلَا يَصِحُ الرَّدُّ عَلَيْهِ And it's not correct to refute him in this matter. With who? With Mirdas al-Rabi'ah. It's not correct to refute him with Mirdas and Rabi'a. Why? فَإِنَّهُمَا صُحَابِيَانِ Because those two are two companions. Mirdas is a companion, and Rabi'a is a companion. مَشْهُورَانِ هُوَ famous. وَالصَّحَابَةِ كُلُّهُمْ عُدُولِ And the companions, all of them are reliable. Whether their narration comes to us from one person or two people, doesn't matter. فَلَا يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى رَفْعِ الْجَهَالَةِ عَنُمْ بِتَعَدُّدِ الرُّوَاتِ A Sahabi doesn't need a number of people to uplift from him. The unknownness of him. That is it required. As for other than a Sahaba, for him to leave the realm of being a majhul, he needs more than one person to narrate from him. Two or more. who any two, nah, al-mashhurina bil-ilm. Those scholars who are known for their knowledge has to, two or more, then you've left the realm of majhul. You're known now. You are known. Aqsamul majhul, the types of majhul. But before I go into that, Khatib al-Baghdadi did narrate from Yahya ibn Ma'in, and that he said, إِذَا رَوَى عَنِ الْمُحَدِّثِ. If a narrator, before I go to another type, Khatib al-Baghdadi narrated that Yahya ibn Ma'in said, إِذَا رَوَى عَنِ الْمُحَدِّثِ. If a narrates from a muhaddith, رَجُلَانِ two men, إِرْتَفَعَ عَنُ إِسْمُ الْجِهَالَةِ. The name Jahala will be uplifted from him. Anybody who two people narrate from him, the name of being a jahala is uplifted from him. Lakin, but قَدْ تَرْتَفِعُ. This is the speech of who? Yahya ibn Ma'in. لَكِنْ قَدْ تَرْتَفِعُ الْجَهَالَةَ بِرِوَايَةِ وَاحِدٍ. But sometimes one person narrating from him, the jahala can be removed from him. إِذَا كَانَ مِنَ النُّقَادِ. That is, if the person who narrated from him is a person who's a naqid. Naqid is a person who's known for this field, who's strong in this field. الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْغُونَ. Those scholars who are nuqat, who don't narrate except from who? إِلَّا عَنِ الثِّقَات. Who don't narrate except from people who are thiqat. Such as who? Imam Malik, Sha'bat ibn Hajjaj, and other than them too. وَغَيْرِهِمَا. Them too, if they narrate from a person, by themselves they can take him out of the realm of jahala. That's what Yahya ibn Ma'in, he said. Ibn Hajar also took that view on board. Because if you go to the Tarjama, the biography of Abdullah ibn Abi Habibat al-Madani, Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he said in his Ta'jeel al-Manfa'ah, he said, قال ابن حذاء. Ibn Hajar said about Abdullah ibn Abi Habibat al-Madani, he said, هو من الرجال الذين اكتفي في معرفتهم برواية مالك عنهم. This man, knowing him, what sufficed us is what? The fact that Imam Malik narrated from him. That's how we know he is not a majhul anymore. He left the realm of Bina in the realm of Jahala. Naam. How many types of Jahala are there? يختلف المجاهيل في قوة الجهالة وضعفها. The Jahala, it differs in terms of its strength, in terms of its strength and in terms of its weakness. And because of that, because of its strength and its power, the scholars, they divided the jahala into three types. They divided into how much? Three types. Because of how it's, the strength of it. They're not all the same level. There's some are very strong jahala, some are very normal. The first type is called majhul al-dhat. Majhul al-dhat means what? It is the narrator. الَّذِي لَمْ يُصَرِّحْ بِاسْمِهِ. Who has not put down... It's the narrator who hasn't mentioned his name. He didn't mention his name. Or بِمَا يَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ. Or anything that indicates his name. So we don't even have his name. So not even his name is known. That one... Sometimes the scholars don't call it jahala to that, they call it mubham. It's a person unknown. Like remember, جَاءَ رَجُّلٌ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. A man came to the messenger. His name is not mentioned, is it? But the sahabas don't harm us because the sahabas, إِبْهَامُ الصَّحَابَةِ لَا يَضُرْ. The fact that the sahabas are not known is not going to harm us. Correct? What are the causes that bring jahala to that? What causes it? Two reasons. عدم التصريح باسم الراوي. The first one is the fact that the name of the narrator is not written. That's one cause. The second one is كثرة النعوت الراوي. The narrator has a nickname. And so people start not knowing his name. He becomes very famous for something he does, a profession that he does, methylene. فيشتهر بشيء منها فيذكر بغير ما اشتهر به لغرض من الأغراض فيظن أنه راو آخر فيحصل الجهل به. So people start not knowing who he is.